Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss about two questions. One question is on design compressive strength formula and other question is on lacing provision.
So if you see this question, so once go through this question, a steel column consisting of ISMB. So what is meant by ISMB? Indian Standard Medium beam, okay, that we discussed in the introduction itself. So a steel column consists of ISMB 400. So 400 is overall depth of that. Okay, usually as a column we use angle, channel or I section. Okay, so that is the I section we are going to use as a column. As one end restrained against translational rotation, what is the meaning of it? So one end is fixed while other end is restrained against translation only. It means it is not restrained against rotation. What is other end there? Pin, or you can say inch. So one end is fixed and other end is inch for that column. Agree? Next, its unsupported length is 5 meter. Its unsupported length is 5 meter. So I am writing, so solution, if you see, so if you observe about column, one end is inch and other end is fixed. So that is given. And unsupported length, what is meant by unsupported length? From year to year, how much this is given in the question? Unsupported length L is equal to 5 meter. Unsupported length L is equal to 5 meter. Next, determine its axial load carrying capacity at service load. See, you have to be very careful about this word. So if at all service load is mentioned, then no need to multiply with a load factor. Agree or not? So if you multiply, then it is known as factor load. But here is asking us to find service load. It means no need to multiply with factor. Agree? Determine its load carrying capacity service load as per IS 800 2007. So as per IS 800 2007 means it is a limit state method. Agree? It is a limit state method. Now in this question, everything is given to is given for the calculation or carrying out the question. So see here, the strength, of course, we are discussed in our conceptual case. Okay, in our conceptions, whenever we are discussing the conceptual concepts or in our conceptual level only, we have discussed about this. But in this question, it is given. So now the desired compressive strength, FCD, is equal to 1 by 5 plus under root 5 square minus lambda into Fy by gamma n naught. So this, we of course, we have discussed, but everything is given in this question. How simple it is? Of course, just for looking, this question seems to be very big. Are very difficult. Okay, but here this is very simple question. So we can do it within some 2 to 3 steps. The such in a simple question. But first of all, you should know about this question and we should know about the concepts. Okay, if you are familiar with the concept, then it is a very simple question. Why? Because everything is given in the question itself. So we are supposed to substitute values and we have to carry out it. That's it. That is only the thing. Now finally, it is asking us to find the axial load carrying capacity. Now if you see here, first let us calculate the effective length, KL. So how much the KL? So KL for when two end, one end is fixed and other end is fixed. How much it is? 0.8L. Agree or not? So L is 0.8 into 5 meters, so convert it to mm. So how much final effective length KL? So use calcis, okay? So 0.8 into 5000. So it is 4000 mm. That is effective length. Agree? So now for the calculation, we know that what is the axial load carrying capacity? Axial load carrying capacity PD is equal to AE into FCD. Agree or not? So AE is given in the question. AE here is gross area of that ISMB. Okay, Indian Standard Medium Beam. So it is given. So AE here is nothing but AG. How much it is? 7846 mm square. Now we are supposed to find FCD. That's it. So for that FCD, what is the formula that is given in the questions? Actually, we have to remember it, but most number of cases they will give it. But from an objective point of view, it is better to remember this formula. So what is the formula? 1 by 5 plus under root 5 square minus lambda square into Fy by. So gamma m naught is also given in the question. How much it is? 1.1. And Fy is given in the question. How much it is? 300 MPa. So 300 MPa mega mega pascal. What is meant by that? So mega pascal is equal to newton per mm square, millimeter square. That is given. Now come to phi. So phi is equal to, the formula is given in the question. Phi is equal to 0.5 into 1 plus alpha into lambda minus 0.2 into lambda square. So to get the value of phi, we should know the value of alpha and lambda. So if you see here alpha, of course for this alpha also we have discussed the values. But in this question it is mentioned that alpha take the value of, it is mentioned to take the value of alpha as a 0.34. So alpha value is also given. So now to get the value of phi, we have to find out the value of lambda. So what is lambda? We know that lambda is a non-dimensional slenderness ratio whose formula is equal to under root Fy by Fcc. So here we have to find this lambda. Agree or not? So for that Fy is given in the question, but we have to find Fcc. Again for Fcc also the formula is given in the question, that is pi square E by KL R whole square. So here we have to find Fcc. Why? Because FCC value is not given, formula is given. So first find FCC. So what is the formula? FCC pi square E. So E is how much? E is how much given in the question? 200 GPa. So this gigapascal means 10 to the power 9. Okay, gigapascal 10 to the power 9 newton per meter square. Convert into MPa. So if you convert into MPa, how much it is? 2 into 10 to the power 5, 200 into 10 cube MPa. So megapascal is nothing but newton per mm square. Agree or not? So now E is nothing but 2 into 10 power 5. So units here I am writing. We can convert it as 200 into 10 cube MPa. So megapascal MPa is equal to newton per mm square. This is a simple units conversion. So 2 into 10 power 5 by KL. Just now we have calculated KL. How much KL? 4000 by R minimum. It is given in the question. How much it is? 28.2 whole square. So come on, calculate the value of FCC again. Use calci. Pi square into 2 into 10 to the power 5. Next. Divided by 4000 by 28.2 whole square. So FCC value comes out to be 98.11 newton per mm square. So that is the value of FCC. So after getting FCC, can we find the value of lambda? Yes, of course we can find the value of lambda. So lambda is equal to under root Fy by FCC. Fy how much? 300 MPa. So 300 MPa is nothing but Fy, here it is 300 MPa. So 300 MPa is nothing but newton per mm square. So 300 by 98.11. How much? So again calculate it. 300 by 98.11. So it is 1.75. So now every value is known to us. Okay, every value is known to us. So simply substitute the values in the given formula. Agree or not? Substitute the values in given formula. So I am going to rub that upper portion of the question so that I will continue the numerical. So I am going to rub this. So lambda value is known, alpha is known, FCC is known, everything is known. So now PFCD. So FCD is nothing but FCD is equal to, so first calculate the value of phi. Okay. So after calculating the value of phi, we go for FCD. So first calculate the value of phi. So phi is equal to 0.5 into 1 plus alpha is how much? 0.34 into lambda is 1.75 minus 0.2. Plus 1.75 whole square. So this is the value of phi. So come on, calculate the value of phi. 0.5 into 1 plus 0.34 into 1.75 minus 0.2 plus 1.75 whole square. So its value is comes out to be 2.29. So we can take as 2.29. Agree, 295. That is the value of phi. After getting the value of phi, calculate the FCD. So FCD is nothing but how much? 1 by 5. So, 5 value is 2.295 plus under root 2.295 whole square minus lambda. So, lambda value is 1.75 whole square into Fy is given in the question 300. So, 300 by the factor of safety, partial factor of safety 1.1. So, now substitute these values. So, as we have substituted these values, some come and evaluate it. So, use calcis. So, it is 1 by 2.295 plus under root 2.295 whole square minus lambda. So, lambda value is 1.75. Non-dimensional centeredness ratio into 300 by 1.1. So now finally, the value of FCD comes out to be 72.15 Newton per mm square. So this is the value of design compressive stress or strength. After getting this, simply use that formula, axial load carrying capacity. Axial load carrying capacity. Okay, PD. So PD is equal to how much? AG, so that is 7846 mm square the unit, and FCD is 72.15. How much? Okay, 72.15 into 7846. So we are going to get it in Newton, so convert into kilonewton. So it is 566.1 kilonewton. So this much of axial load it will take. So now PD, how much? Finally, PD is equal to 566.1 kilonewton. So this is the axial load carrying capacity of the given column, ISMP. So take it out. So everything is simple. So everything is given in the question. Only we should be aware of evaluating the values, and we should be aware of the, so I can say at the conceptual level, we should be very strong. So if you are strong in, if you are strong at conceptual level, then it is a very simple question. Within a fraction of seconds, we can do it. So see here, in this question, first we have to find the L effective. After that, we should know this formula. So after that, everything is there in the question. So FCD formula is given. So we have to first get, after that, we have to calculate FCC and then lambda and then phi and substitute in the given formula. So that's it. Okay. So the next question, if you observe, a very simple question. Okay, one mark you can say. A built-up column is connected by a lacing system. So here we have made a built-up column. So that built-up column is made by a lacing system and is subjected to a service load. So once I am repeating, see here, service load, it means factor of safety or load factor is not included here. Okay, service load of 1000 kilonewton. The lacing should be designed to resist a transverse shear of. So that is what is asking the question, and options are given. So we know that. So how much the transverse shear force the lacing system is subjected to? So it's subjected to a transverse shear force of V, which is equal to 2.5 P by 100. Agree or not? So here P is nothing but factored design load. Agree or not? So how much P is equal to 1.5 the load factor into the service load. So it is 1000. So how much it is? 1500 kilonewton. Agree? So now substitute here. P is equal to 2.5 into that 1500 by 100. So we can cancel the two zeros. And the answer comes out to be 37.5 kilonewton. Very simple question. So the only the trickiness in this question here is, this is not the factor load. So service load means load factor is not included. Now which option it is? Third option, 37.5. Okay, so take down.